Today's video was recorded in 4K with the Elgato Gaming 4K 60 Pro. Click my link in the description below if you want to learn more. It finally happened. It took me a little bit over 620 reserves, and that is all in-game time, by the way, no money spent, in order to get the S6 Stingray. This is definitely a worst case scenario. I basically had no items remaining in this collection, and it came all the way down to that in order to get this from my duplicate protected rerolls. So yeah, that really sucks. It took a long time. But how is the S6 Stingray? I'm sure you've seen a lot of people with gameplay like the one you've been watching having explosive rounds with the operator mod that comes with it. I will admit this is extremely powerful. You're able to get a one burst kill, especially if the enemy is not using Flak Jacket as their perk. If someone is using Flak Jacket, it will negate some of the damage and provide them a chance to fire back. But otherwise, if you pair this thing up with the explosive ammunition, the hybrid mag, and a laser sight, hip firing with this is extremely deadly. I cannot believe they put this behind a reserve. That's how powerful this is. For the sake of this gameplay though, I am not going to use the explosive round. I want to show you how powerful it is without the explosive rounds, because I still feel like you're able to do a ton of damage. So what makes the S6 Stingray unique in itself? Well, first off, it doesn't fire actual bullets. It fires a projectile, kind of like harpoons, mini harpoons. It takes a little bit of time for those projectiles to connect with the enemy that's in front of you. And you will notice a lot of the time when you're playing with this weapon, if you ever pick it up off the ground or even in this gameplay, you may notice it, I'm shooting ahead of the enemy, and that's because you need to lead your target a little bit so those harpoons will land on target every single time. It's something that I still tend to struggle with, even though I've been using this thing for a few hours now. The harpoons themselves will penetrate armor, since you can't put an FMJ attachment on this. I noticed it just goes right through armor, and you can still kill enemies just as fast. The main setup that I like to use will be the long barrel, the suppressor, hybrid magazine, and laser sight. I know it sounds like a lot of attachments for this specific weapon, but there's a lot of time where you may need to hipfire, and having that laser sight definitely comes in handy. The hipfire without the laser sight actually isn't that bad, but having that adds that extra accuracy that you need to make sure you can clean up targets that are directly in your face. The suppressor is just there to keep me off the radar. It doesn't actually change the damage profile, and it says it changes range, but I don't really notice it because I still use the long barrel. Now you might be thinking to yourself, well, that would just offset it, but the long barrel has an added benefit for this specific weapon. It allows your projectiles to leave the barrel faster, meaning they'll make it to your target faster, and this is something that you definitely want to have on. Without it, you're going to be leading a lot farther than you normally would, and with it, it makes it feel more like a normal bullet pattern that you're used to. I'm not going to sugarcoat it for you guys. This is an incredibly powerful weapon. So powerful, in fact, that it's already gone through one nerf to change how the cycle is for its burst to slow it down just a little bit, but it still is pretty fast and you're still able to get pretty easy kills. Now, I'm not saying this so they would nerf it or anything. I don't want anyone to think that. I'm simply just saying this because it's the truth. This thing is freaking powerful. It's incredible that they put this behind a reserve. Oh yeah, and you might be wondering about the sight. That's just the standard iron sight. I actually kind of like it. I think it's because it looks more futuristic and kind of like a halo weapon. But if you don't like it, there are tons of options for you to choose from. You can put on the thermal sight, the threat detector, dual zoom, holographic, reflex sight. Basically a cornucopia of reticles. You got some choices if you want to actually use something else. You don't have to stick with this weird looking alien like sight that I have on there. As for standard attachments, you have hybrid magazine, laser sight, rapid fire. You actually can put on the grip, which I don't really feel like the grip does much for this specific weapon, but hey, if it floats your boat, it's there for you to choose. You have the long barrel, you have a suppressor, and finally you have the quick draw handle that you can choose from in order to aim down sight a little bit faster. And then you got the big daddy impact blast, which is the operator mod that gives you the explosive ammunition. So I just want to say once again, even though this thing may look extremely powerful and you may want it really bad, please do not spend money on reserves. The chances of you getting one of these weapons is literally under 1% as of right now. There's so many filler items in the reserves that you're honestly better off waiting for the weapon bribes to come through, and I truly hope you don't get Mark II weapons from the weapon bribes when contracts do eventually make their way into the game on Tuesday. So I just want to add some of my personal thoughts right here at the end about the S6 Stingray. This is by far one of the most enjoyable weapons I've ever used in the game. And that's because it's one of those fun weapons. A fun weapon to me is like a ballistic knife or a nail gun like we've seen in previous games. It's not something that needs to be taken seriously, and it gives us a chance to do something new, something unique, and that's where they've kind of fallen off when it comes to content for multiplayer. The disparity between the content that's provided by doing challenges and in-game stuff and playing specific modes versus the stuff that's been added to the black market is pretty jarring, because here's the issue that I see, or the conundrum that I see. I know that there are a lot of you out there who watch my videos that don't like the blackout mode. You are more in tune with standard multiplayer. And when you don't have anything to do, and I mean that very sincerely, when there's nothing to do, when you don't want to work on challenges, when you're done with your camo challenges, when you're already master rank and you don't care about level 1000, and there's really nothing left to do, when they keep stacking things into the black market, it doesn't necessarily make you want to play the game, because then you're saying, well, if I want to continue playing this game or continue enjoying it, I'm going to have to spend, you know, $10 to get this or $20 to get that. That's not the way to do things. And when you take weapons that are vital, might I add, to the multiplayer experience, and put them behind a paywall, that's when you start to make your community very, very upset. And I can definitely see why everyone is extremely upset with this game in regard to that alone. I mean, there's way, way more things that have gone wrong, but I just realized I went off topic and I apologize. It's just something that I'm passionate about, man. You know, I play the game every single day. I want to see it succeed, and it just sucks that there's just so much good that happens, and then on top of that, everything just gets shadowed by bad, negative things, and it just makes everyone sour about everything. But back to the topic of the S6 Stingray. I actually really like the weapon. I think it's unique. I think it's creative. I love the fact that they went the extra mile and added animations to literally have the enemy's legs fall off or get chopped in half, arms falling off. If you end up hitting them in that specific area with the standard harpoons, that's really cool. I like that they went that extra mile and did that. What I don't like is that I had to dump hundreds upon hundreds of hours going through duplicate upon duplicate in order to get this, and it, like I said at the beginning of this video, totally a worst case scenario, you know, happening right there at the end of everything. No one could have predicted that, but that's the problem with RNG. That's the problem with random numbers generating everything and oh, you're going to get this time, and you're going to get that time. I've had tons and tons of you over on Twitter sending me images of your weapon bribes, and you were getting like two weapons in one. Some of you got the Locust and the Ballistic Knife at the same time. Some of you are getting the S6 and a couple of Mark II weapons at the same time. And I could not believe your luck. If you have luck like that, literally play the lottery. But it's never been with me in all of these games. Since Advanced Warfare, I've never had luck like that. I've always had to struggle and dump tons and tons of time into the game. And it sucks as a YouTuber, because I want to bring you this content. See, before my excuse was, oh, I'm a YouTuber, so I'm going to spend a bunch of money, I'm going to get these weapons, and then I'll, you know, make videos on them. But that's, I don't want to be that person anymore. And I don't know if you guys have noticed that, but I haven't been that person this year. I haven't tried to be that person. At the beginning of the year, I may have made a couple of dumb mistakes, and I may have purchased a couple of stupid things from the black market, but I've always vowed to never buy reserves. It's just not worth it. Don't buy reserves. Like, okay, if you're one of those people that want to buy tiers because you know exactly what you're going to get, I don't fault you for that if you wanted to do that. I don't care what you do. No one should care what anyone else does with their money. I'm just saying I was setting a bad example for all of the people who watch my videos, because I was just using that as an excuse. I was saying, well, I'm a YouTuber, let me go ahead and dump $200, $300, $400 into this game, get the weapons that I want, and then I'll make videos about them because I know that it'll pay dividends, it'll pay off in the end. I don't want to be that person anymore. I want to be like you guys. I want to go through and play the game and see how much time it takes, and I want to make sure that I'm constantly in that same struggle that everyone else is. I honestly feel like that has a bigger impact on the things that I say in my videos, and I want to make sure that I'm conveying my honest thoughts and feelings when I'm putting it out there. So yeah, am I happy that I ended up getting the S6 Stingray? Yeah, of course I'm happy. I think anyone would be happy when they get a new gun. I'm just honestly disappointed that it took so long for me to get there. You know, I went through so many duplicates, and yeah, I just know people don't have the time like I do to put into this game. And that's all I want to say. The S6 Stingray is fun. I can definitely see it getting nerfed to shit moving forward because it is a powerful weapon. I'm sure once they see more people get this thing and more people start abusing the explosive rounds, that will get tweaked in some way, shape, or form. But overall, I just want to thank you guys so much for giving me all the continued support here on the channel. Thank you so much for liking my videos, subscribing. Welcome to the team if you're a new subscriber. Over the past few months, it's been incredibly hectic here back at my house. And, you know, my wife and I have been just gearing up for stuff in the future. And, you know, having all the support of you guys has just been really nice. It's been really, really nice to have positivity flowing through my comment section, even when it might be on something negative like supply drops or RNG or whatever. But either way, thank you so much for that. I really appreciate it. It's a nice little pick-me-up that I see every single day when I'm responding to you guys in the comment section or I'm just reading through your comments, because I try to read every single one of them. I still do. I know that a lot of big content creators will call me stupid for doing that, but I personally like reading your comments, and I think that it's nice to have that positivity for once, even in a negative game. But anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate you coming out. If you enjoyed the video, take a moment of your time to click the like button down below. Don't forget to subscribe for more videos coming each and every day. And of course, if you're new to the channel and you haven't yet, ring the bell icon, and that way YouTube will notify you every single time my videos go live. I'll catch you on the next one. Peace.